Good morning, students. We are going to discuss superficial expansion and cubical expansion of solid today. Let us start with the superficial expansion. Superficial expansion means expansion in area. That is when length and breadth of a plate is increased on being heated. This increase is called superficial expansion. So let us see. On what factors will this superficial expansion depends? Superficial expansion depends on three factors, which is original area, then increase in temperature, and material of the plate. Original area is AO and increase in temperature is T. Superficial expansion can be taken as final area minus initial area. So how can we write this? We can write increase in area is proportional to original area. Increase in area is also proportional to increase in temperature. When we combine these two, we find increase in area is proportional to original area into increase in temperature. And now we have to remove this proportionality sign to change into equality. For this we are going to give a constant term, and here the constant will be beta. Beta is the coefficient of superficial expansion. Then original area into temperature. So this is the expression for superficial expansion. Let us now come to cubical expansion. Similarly, we can also write about the cubical expansion. Which is final volume minus original volume. Because cubical expansion is the expansion in terms of length, breadth and the thickness. So altogether the volume will increase when that solid is heated. It also depends on the original volume, increase in temperature and also the nature of the material. So how can we write it? Increase in volume is directly proportional to the original volume. Then increase in volume is directly proportional to increase in temperature. When we combine these two, we can write original volume into temperature. Now here also this proportionality sign is to be removed, which can be given by another constant term, and here the constant is gamma. This is how we are going to write gamma into original volume into temperature. This is another expression for the cubical expansion. Let us now see the relationship between the three coefficients, that is coefficient of linear expansion, coefficient of superficial expansion and also coefficient of cubical expansion. Let us see. So we have relationship between alpha, beta and gamma. You should know alpha is coefficient of linear expansion, beta coefficient of superficial expansion, and gamma is coefficient of cubical expansion. So the relation is that alpha, beta, gamma, alpha is to beta is to gamma is equal to 1:2:3, which means to say that coefficient of cubical expansion is 3 times the coefficient of linear expansion, and also coefficient of cubical expansion is 2 times the coefficient of superficial expansion. So this we have the relation between alpha, beta and gamma. Now we have some applications of thermal expansion. There are many expansion applications. Let's discuss some applications only here. First is the construction of a bridge. You might have seen a bridge which is made of steel. It's a one end is fixed on the wall, but the other end of the steel bridge is supported on the rollers with a small gap between the roller and the wall. This is just given to allow proper expansion of the bridge during the summer season without causing any damage to the brick, to the wall and also to the bridge. So as you know that there is, during the summer season, the steel bridge is going to expand. Since one side is already fixed, now the other side, which is supported on the rollers, will slowly expand and will fill the gap between the roller and the wall without causing any damage to it. You might have seen the railway tracks where there is small gap left at equal interval. Now this gap is also left for the same purpose, just to allow the expansion without causing any damage to the track. Because if this gap had not been given, then in that case, during the summer season when railway tracks expand, it would completely bend due to the expansion, leading to accident. You might have seen the fixing of the wires between the two poles. Again, certain precaution is taken while fixing the wire, and the precaution is that when it is fixed during winter season, it is taken tight between the two poles, so that during summer season when it becomes loose, it won't sag much and will not get damaged, not get broken. On the other hand, if the wire is to be fixed between the two poles during summer season, then in that case it is slightly kept loose, so that during winter it would become tight but won't become much tight, so that it would break. So these are the precautions what are taken when we are fixing the wire between the two poles. Then we have glassware used in the kitchen. They are not an ordinary glass, they are the glass made of Pyrex, which has a very low coefficient of cubical expansion. The reason is that when any hot liquid is poured into the glass, due to this hot liquid, the glass will not expand due to its low coefficient of cubical expansion. And as a result, the glass will not break. So there are other applications also that we can discuss later on. Thank you.